What? I can't hear you. You know what a baby be wearing? You still wear spiritual dampers. I take it again. No matter how much you master the scripture, without true obedience to what you read, you still wear spiritual dampers. Like I said, I just come in here to say hello to you. Well, finally, we come to learn, we continue to learn, and we come to church from far and wide to hear this message of God, and many of us live with Imani TV. We live with what? Yes, that is, as I'm talking now, some of us, we own it in our bedroom. Our children, they own it, put it on all the time. We live with it. Imani TV has become partner in your bedroom, in your city room. Yet, we never mature because of disobedience. Yet, we never mature because of disobedience. Knowledge is not the key, obedience is. Tell your neighbor, we continue learning, coming to church from far and wide, hear message of gospel, yet we never mature because of disobedience. Maturity is all about Christ. When you are not mature, you are ignorant. And ignorance is a sin. Ignorance is a sin. When you are not mature, you react intellectually to the things of God. You react by what you see, and you think it's godly way to do that. You react by what you hear. You say this to me? You mean my wife did this? You saw my wife there? Yes, I saw your wife there. And you not know that he want to scatter your marriage. It's easy to destroy those who are not mature. If you are not mature, you are easy. You are just a fool to Satan. Anytime they see you happy, they will go into a corner and make a phone call to you that, this man is happy, let him give him unhappiness. They will now give you a phone call, hello? Yes. You see, I saw your wife. The place I saw your wife is very, very bad. I'm telling you. You know, it's bad though. Eh? Where? This place, that place, that place. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. you drop the phone and say, I love this woman. I love her. I don't know why you should behave like this to me. You want to commit suicide. Those who have committed suicide, 50% of them, they act ignorantly. What they hear, what they see, what their circumstances look like. So these are the weapons for immature Christians. Act what you see. What you hear, your condition, maybe the doctor give you a report that this go and write your will. You say, no worry, I don't need to write my will. You just get home and commit suicide. I want to leave you here, like I have said, everything big start little. Take note of this word and take it. Work on it. Your challenge determine where you are spiritually. Your challenge could be sickness, could be poverty, could be hardship, could be insult, could be temptation, could be just name. Trial and temptation determine where we are spiritually. How you react when you are under pressure, how you react when you are under that challenge, you will see the way you react is how the real you reacts, is how the real you react. Say, how I react under pressure, I mean under challenge, I mean under your problem. I don't know the condition you are, how you react, maybe hardship or sickness or debt or hardship. How you react is how the real you reacts. And the real you is the one serving God, not you. Your real one, the real you. I take it back again. You are here today because you have transport to come to the church, or you are able to fuel your car. Assume you have no money to fuel your car. You will likely send your children to the church and sit at home because you don't want to be shamed by people around you. And you have forgotten that the same God that gave you the vehicle, that gave you the car, you were nobody before. And the Lord now give you the vehicle, and you are now using the same vehicle against him. Assume you have money to transport here, or you have no money to fare your car, you will likely not come to the service today. Okay, when we start, you have been watching people when they were dancing. You, by looking at the way people dance, you know who is this man. Whether he's coming to share, to give testimony, or he's coming with trouble. You see some dance, they'll do like this. Why some does would say, hallelujah, hallelujah. You know that Satan has hit him. Do you know now, if you receive a phone call as we are talking now, something you have been expecting, long time, money you have been expecting, a huge money, you have waited and waited and waited. You just receive a phone call. Hello? Hello? Hey, I'm so. I just cash the money now. Cash, and I'm bringing it to your house. Eh? Eh? Say it again. You mean what? You cash money and you are bringing it to my house. You don't look around. Where is Usher? Usher, come. Where is the restroom here?
Over there, sir.
Where?
The other side.
Other side. He's not going to restroom, oh. He want to make that phone call proper, to hear proper inside the... He will not dial the number. Hello? Yeah, I can hear you now. He heard inside the church, but he want to hear clearly. Hello, I can hear you now. You say what? Well, I have cashed the money. I'm very close to your house. Ha. TB Joshua prayer has answered then. I don't need to wait. And I've not prayed today. Before you know, he will just even the Bible, he will forget the Bible at the table here. Because a lot of Bible we keep collected every Sunday. Today now, a lot of Bible, but we never see £1 or $1 on the table. The usher, the sanitation, they keep packing the Bible. A lot of Bible, every Sunday at least you will find almost 100 Bible. But we have not found $1 or 1 naira on the table. They will never forget that one. Trial and temptation determine where you are spiritually. How you react under pressure, how you react under your situation, is how the real you reacts. Tell your neighbor how you react under pressure. I mean, under your challenges, is how the real you reacts. You are, you see, many of us, we are sitting down and saying we love Jesus. If there are so much very nice appointment for you, so nice appointment, you can get whatever you need, you will not come here today. So, and Jesus is not one of those things, it's the only thing. Are you with me? I say every one of us, we are sitting down today, I say we love Jesus so much. If we have so much, so nice appointment for today, and you need to go somewhere, which you know something will come out of it, you will likely not come here today. Jesus is not one of those things, it's the only. Rise up for prayer. I will offer prayer with you, and I will now leave the rest for my evangelist to continue with. I want to take you back because a lot you have lost. Lost time, lost hope, lost dream. I remember when I was very young, all my dream is what is coming to fulfillment. I can, when something happened to me, I would remember, I dream it. When I was in secondary school those days, those dreams I used to have, each come to pass one by one. And believe that if your dream has been coming to pass, you would not be where you are today. You are not created to be tail, but to be head. You have lost dream, a lot of dream. Are you with me? If you recall your dream in the past, 10 years, 20 years ago, you will remember that those dreams has not come to pass. Where you eat with king, queen, president of nation, and you find yourself in a palace, yet you have never been to a palace till now. So right now, let us go to that which we have lost. Let us go to that which we have lost. Tell your neighbor. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Yes. Right now, begin to recollect, recover your lost dream. Prayer. Begin to recover your lost dream. Your lost dream. Your lost dream. I command you right now to recover your lost dream. Your lost dream. You have once dreamed you are a king, but today you are on the streets. You once dreamed in the name of Jesus Christ. You won't dream seeing yourself a president of a nation, but today you are still on the street. You once dream see yourself in the palace, controlling palace, but today you know opposite is what you are doing now. You once dreamed seeing yourself with crown and people were bowed before you. Today, you are still on the street. I command you to recover your lost dream. In the name of Jesus, your lost dream, recover them in the name of Jesus. Those dreams are not just for fun. They are not nightmares. They are real. They are real. Are you listening to me? If those dream are nightmare, I will not recollect mine. May it come one by one since I was born, the dream I had, all those things, I realized that it come one after another. They are not nightmare. But to you see them as nightmare. Nowadays, when you now dream, see yourself eating with president of a nation, and the president of nature is giving you a check. A president of nature is giving you command, okay, I give you this, go and do this. You can consider it as a nightmare because you have been dreaming in the past. Nothing came to fulfillment. Your lost hope and your lost dream, in the name of Jesus, recover them. Recover them. Recover them. Your lost marriage, recover them. Recover them. Recover them. Open your lips and begin to recover them. This is anointing upon you to recover all your lost. Your loss, all your loss, all your loss.
Vous avez perdu votre mariage perdu, recouvrez-les dans le nom de Jésus-Christ, priez.
Jesus Christ, I release you from influence of ancestral circle. The same thing that happened to your brother is the same thing that is happened to you now. The same thing that happened to your sister is the same thing that happened to you. What is happening in the house is what is happening to you. I release you in the name of Jesus. Yes. What is happening in the house is what is happening to you. What is happening to your family is what is happening to you. This is ancestral circles. Ancestral circle. I release you from that influence. Be released in the name of Jesus. Be released in the name of Jesus. Open your lips and begin to release yourself.
Vous-même du cycle ancestral qui se trouve dans votre vie. Ce qui vous arrive, c'est ce qui arrive à quelqu'un d'autre dans la maison, dans la famille. Libérez-vous de ce cycle ancestral dans le nom de Jésus-Christ.
Empieza a liberarse de este círculo generacional. Empieza a liberarse en el nombre poderoso de Jesucristo. En su vida. Observe la pantalla, la acción y la reacción de las personas ante la oración.
Continuez de prier, téléspectateurs. L'homme de Dieu a dit de se libérer des cycles ancestraux. Vous devez réaliser que ce qui se passe dans votre vie aujourd'hui, c'est ce qui se passe dans la vie de votre soeur, de votre frère ou de vos parents. Libérez-vous de ce cycle ancestral dans le nom de Jésus-Christ. Priez.
Ancestral en su vida. Toque su pantalla y
respire. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every area of your life seems not complete. Even your marriage, your business, your career seems not complete. With the name of Jesus, we can restore that which is required to complete your marriage. You are working with the Lord. There are some areas that are not complete. Open your lips now and begin to restore that which is required to complete your working with the Lord. Your marriage, your business. Open your lips, open your lips.
Incomplet, avec le nom de Jésus, vous pouvez restaurer ce qui est requis pour compléter votre vie, compléter votre mariage et tout ce qui vous concerne.
Toute l'area de su vida que no está completada, sea completada en nombre poderoso de Jesucristo, restaurada para ser completada. Caminamos en el Señor, ser restaurados.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray. You may be seated, thank you. I think I have some message which I'm trying to check up here. I received so much letter where I don't know. I'm not coming out because of this, but I just God say I should come out. It has to do with many nations here. I'm a first United States of America, two, our nation, and three, Southern Africa in general. I want to share with you what I saw 10 days ago. I saw the new president of America. That was 10 days ago. That's why I say I saw. That's 10 days ago, I saw the new president of America with a narrow winning. With a narrow win. With a narrow win. And the new president will be facing challenges. Over many issues. Including passing B, attempt to possibly pass a vote of no confidence in the future. I will just reserve the name for now. Maybe at the end of the day I will tell you the name is here. The new president will face several challenges, and some of the challenges include passing bills. These are the challenges that will come from time to time. An attempt to even possibly pass a vote of no confidence. Why should this happen? But in summary, I can see that the boat of the new president will be rocked. Boat will be rocked. That is, so I think this is. So I will keep this in touch with me. But I will continue. Let me try to begin at home first. There are many issues. Yeah. So I want to leave this place for my people to come and take over. Can I? Hi, how are you? How are you? You people are together?
Yes, with my wife.
Your wife has a strange spirit.
Yes, man of God. Yes, man of God.
A strange spirit in the sense that today is happy, tomorrow is sad.
She has a spirit of hunger.
And when it's sad, you will be begging her to show love to you.
Exactly, that's what I'm doing.
Because of that, several times you sleep out in the sitting room and she will sleep inside the room.
Yes, man of God.
And she told you, even the saddening thing is that of recent she told you that he has no affection.
Sure. Yes, man of God.
Very sure, man of God. Help say, me, man of God.
He said, my dear, I don't have affection for you again. And you are very sad about it.
Deliver us, man of God.
Deliver me, man of God.
No, I must tell you what you need to be delivered. I don't deliver people without telling you what you... So this has been a challenge.
Yes,
and a baby boy she would have delivered, it came down.
Exactly, man of God.
She was pregnant and the whole thing came down.
Yes, man of God.
And a baby boy, it came down. And today it's
nearly... He is suffering, man of God. It's 9 years since we've been married. We have no issue.
That's what I'm saying. I said she was pregnant of baby boy and the thing came down.
Yes, man of God.
So it has been like that. And there was a time she attempted to leave the house, and if about half of her luggage was outside, and she had to return it back.
Exactly. Good. Exactly.
Okay. Thank you. Come on, sir. This is spirit of death. So you keep eating with the dead people.
Yes, sir. It's true. It's true, sir. It's correct.
I want to see. That is the mountain before you now. That is the mountain before you.
Okay, sir.
My brother, hey, marry and remarry.
Yes, it's in our family, man of God.
Marry and remarry.
In our family.
And attempt, you know, your attempt in the past. God loves you so much.
Thank you, please. I had an accident 3 weeks ago, head-on collision.
Look, what I was saying before calling you spirit of death, I saw your coffee, and the Lord was telling me, this man is here, it's a miracle. I should talk to him. So this man is here, it's a miracle. So this is why I say this is spirit of death. And not only that, there is a woman that died that always appeared to you. Madam, menstruation cease.
It's true.
Can you hear me clear?
Yes.
Look, come on, come here. I don't know where to go. I'm just going around, just like that. How about you, sir?
I know, man of God.
Oh, yes, there's a letter in your possession.
Amen.
There's a letter in your possession.
Amen.
Don't doubt what is written there.
Yeah, it's a medical report. Medical report on my medical report on my condition. Medical report on sugar diabetes.
This is the second time now.
Yes.
You are received. The first one you receive.
Amen.
And you turn it.
I've not believed it.
I do. You don't believe it.
Exactly.
Okay. Don't worry. You come on. Thank come
you.
On. Okay.
Thank
you. Can I talk to you? Come on. How are you? See, to scream in the dream. You used to see her when she screamed.
Yes.
And sometimes when she screamed, you slap her.
She's scared.
Huh?
She's very scared every time in the night.
I can't hear you.
She's scared always.
I'm not so scared. I say when she sleep, sometimes she just shout.
Yes.
Scream.
I say greet her voice. It's true.
So there is a major issue he told you about someone he was friending before know you. No, you. She is your wife. Who is she to you?
She's my wife.
I say she told you something about someone he was friendly in the past. She told you something. I say you. She told you. Okay, come on. You have depression.
Yes, sir.
The depression in the way that even you are started using tablets.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
To subdue that depression. Depression has no drug, has no medicine. It's an attack. When someone is having depression, there's no medicine. The highest thing you can do, apart from praying, is to counsel. The person needs counseling.
That's why I come here, sir. I will take pills to sleep.
Because you say you're taking a tablet because you are depressed, because you are disappointed.
Yes, sir.
This actually afflicted you through disappointment.
Yes, sir.
You are disappointed.
Yes, sir.
And two times now you come to conclusion of committing suicide.
Yes, sir.
Even you look at the room, you say you want to commit suicide.
Yes, sir. I ask God, if I have to live the way I live, why do I need to live? He could take me home.
Can I talk to you, brother? There's a lost spirit, spirit of loss.
Yes, man of God.
And you don't know how it came to your life.
Yes, it's through man of God.
It came to your life, you don't know. Sometimes you sleep, you will see yourself wet.
Yes, yes.
So you have to do some restitution because there's someone who used to be a prostitute in the past.
Yes, man of God.
That came to your life.
Yes.
The woman here, I don't know, where is she? Okay. Where's your husband? And I'm asking the woman here, you never want to answer me. Okay, you go and sit down. I want to see you.
It's true.
Huh?
What you said about menstruation is true. Usually, instead of me having them every 4 weeks, I get them every.
That is not even the issue. The issue is a baby coming to you in the night when you dream. In the past, they will be coming as if they play with your breasts.
Yes.
A little baby. As if you are giving them breast, you are feeding them with
yes,
the breast.
That's very true, man of God.
And when you wake up, your breast becoming heavy.
That's very true, man of God.
There are more to that. You can't sit down.
We've been trying to have it.
God, wait for me. Hey, how are you? How are you, brother?
Fine.
You have challenges in your blood.
Yes.
But when you walk a little, you get fainted as if you want to collapse.
Yes.
Get dizzy.
Yes, man of God.
How are you, brother? Come on. There are two countries you need to travel to before you have a settlement. You have been to one.
Yes, sir.
I want to see you.
Okay, sir.
Okay? Just
yes,
to counsel, you give you a counseling.
Okay, sir.
God loves you.
I know.
You know God loves you.
Yes, sir.
Because you will have been wasted in the sea.
Yes, sir.
That is sea. For somebody to jump inside the sea and die, you will have end up your life there. God loves you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
I want to see you. How are you?
I'm good, sir.
Where's your wife?
It's around.
Okay, don't worry about that. That is not the problem. You emotionally, you have challenges. Your sexual, this is weak.
Yes, sir.
And emergency cannot solve this problem. It's family problem.
Yes, sir.
Because if you look at your brother, the same challenges.
Yes, sir.
So I want to see you, okay?
Thank
God
you.
God loves you. Okay, so thank you. Brother, how are you?
Fine.
You pray against oppression.
Yes.
Oppression.
Yes.
Oppression.
Yes.
It was looking like anemia before.
Yes.
But the issue is not anemia again.
Yes.
It's bigger than anemia.
Uh-huh.
So I want to see you, okay?
Okay.
Okay, how are you, brother? How are you?
I'm fine.
How are you? Someone died in the family?
My dad.
And he left some will for you. Some little property. It's not even nearly. We will not consider it as a will, by the way. But I really want to see you because there's a curse in the family. Because this is spiritual inheritance you have. So because the genesis of your journey, you have been donated.
Okay.
You have a spiritual challenges.
Yes, I've been experiencing that.
Challenges, and suddenly they give you a job, at the end of the day they sack you. You just live from one place to another.
It's true.
Okay, sometimes somebody will call you, you will not be able to trace the person that called you.
It's true.
So that is it. And two, there's what we call pie.
Sorry?
Pie. There's a pie in the family. Okay? Okay? I want to see you. How are you, sir? So you pray against tumor.
Okay, sir.
Tumor.
Yes, sir.
That causes serious headache.
Yes, sir.
Tumor around it causes serious headache, and when you have this headache, you cannot sleep, you cannot do anything.
That's it, sir.
So I want to see you. Okay, come on. Who is Felix? Felix. How are you, brother? Where's your wife?
That's my wife.
There's a problem in the house.
That's very correct. That's why we are prophet. That's very correct. That's why we are here.
Because when two of you sit together, there's a big problem.
That's very, very correct, prophet.
For the past 3 months now, this house have not been in order.
That's 100% correct, prophet.
It's like a cat and rat living together.
100%. I can't say anymore. 100%.
You have to help this auntie. You have to help her.
Okay, prophet.
You just have to help her.
Okay, prophet.
So don't use the family she come from working against her, because she come from disorganized family.
Okay, prophet. Okay, I hear you, prophet. Thank you very much.
I want to see you.
Thank you.
And leaving this family, leaving this woman, it will affect you.
Oh, yes,
because it's a woman God has given you.
Thank you, prophet. Thank you very much.
So you were bleeding in the past.
Prophet, that's very true.
Huh?
That's very true.
What was the cause of the bleeding?
I don't know what really was, but I have two fibroids in my womb.
Apart from fibroid.
Okay, I used to have imbalance in my hormones, so when the doctor tried to correct it, then they...
Because I'm still bleeding.
Yes, it's very true.
I want to see you, people. And you don't have affection for this woman. It is not her that does not have affection. You don't have affection.
I don't know what's the problem, prophet.
Yeah? It's very true, man of God. She
loves you. She wants to show love, but you... He said, go and wait there,
That's very true.
And it has now turned to somebody you employ, not even wife. I think I need to see you.
Thank you, prophet. Thank you very much, prophet.
You're a nice man, please.
Thank you very much.
That's well. So don't worry, what is that? Because of time.
It's my mother-in-law, prophet. She lives with us.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, don't worry. God wait for me. You say what?
There is trouble in their house.
Don't worry, I've said it already. Don't worry. You know, the young people today, they don't want you people to interfere in their family.
Thank you, Mama.
Okay, go and wait for me. Go and wait for me. They want to fight their battle. They don't want that. Everything will be all right. Okay, thank you, brother. How are you? This is a vast land.
Okay.
There's a vast land.
Okay.
You know what I mean? There's a lot of land.
I don't understand.
This is family possession. So okay. Go and wait for me. How are you? So maybe, with the language, I don't know the language, he will speak better, okay? Talk to him. How are you?
Fine, sir.
There is a controversy over a child.
A child?
There is a controversy, trouble over a child. So go and wait for me. So it's your husband? I want to see two of you. How are you? Thank you. Come on. Come this way. Don't worry. Leave her. There's a seer in the house.
Okay.
There's a woman that is a seer. So you are given birth to a promise to idol, the worship idol in your family.
Okay.
This has affected you greatly. Sometimes you cannot reason well. So I want to see you, okay?
Yes, man of God.
And that cause there's a challenge, a child who has physical challenge.
Okay.
Come on. Okay, thank you. How are you? When's your child?
Sorry?
Your baby girl. Come back. There's an adopted child. So, okay?
Yes.
You have to keep and make sure you take care of this child. Okay? God loves you. And the two, your kidney.
Yes, man of God, that is a problem.
Your kidney.
Yes.
Because of this kidney, you cannot run toilet, you cannot go to the toilet.
Speak. Yes, man of God. Yes, man of God, is it true?
That's very true.
Okay, don't worry. It will be all right, okay?
Okay.
It will be all right. Go wait for me. Thank you. This is polygamy.
Yes.
Come on. I say this is polygamy.
Okay. I can hear you, man of God.
I say this is polygamy.
Okay.
They don't want you to have a settled home.
Yes.
There's an image.
Yes.
Worship.
Okay. Yes, man of God.
Donc j'ai dit que c'est une maison polygame pour l'adoration d'idoles.
Comment can I talk to you? How are you? You have issue with diplomats.
Oui, sir.
You pray so immigration so that you will not have issue with them.
Yes, man of God.
I said you have issue with immigration. So you have to pray, okay?
Thank you, man.
Because I'm seeing invitation. This is an invitation. So you pray, okay?
Okay, thank you, man.
And two, at downside of you, an attempt of surgery.
Yes, that's very true.
And this given you problem, the problem is not yet solved.
Yes, man of God, yes.
Come on, come. What normally happened to you when you sleep, it has started again. When you know, those days when you sleep, you find your body wet.
Yes, yes, man of God.
Speak louder.
Yes, man of God.
It's an attack. You thought maybe it's just, maybe you take too much water.
Yes, man of God.
But it started again. So it will not see you bedwetting, wet in the bed.
Yes, man of God.
This is what I'm seeing you. It's an attack, and that will cost you your marriage and everything around you. Come on. Come on, how are you? Where's your Bible? You have a calling. You have a calling.
Yes, man of God.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
What do I say? I say you have a calling.
Yes, man of God. It's true.
This is an evangelist.
Yes.
But you are going too far. Wait and receive the gift, the area God wants to use you before you go into establish church.
Yes.
But you are going too far now.
Yes, man of God.
You understand what I'm saying?
It's true, man of God. He had a dream that he's been prayed by man, given money. And it's a calling that
is received. There's a spirit of death in the family.
Yes, ma'am.
And they don't run for your family.
Yeah.
But for some time now, you're trying to avoid them.
Yes, it's true.
You run for the family.
It's true, man of God.
Don't run for your family. Okay. Nothing will happen, but you are ahead in the family. If you run for family, who will put the family together?
Yes, yeah, true, man of God.
Okay. Where is this boy?
Excuse me, man of God.
There's a boy.
My boy.
Your boy.
Yes, man of God.
I say you have a boy.
Yes, man of God.
Uh-huh. So take care of the boy. You know, sometimes when you give birth to the child, there was no hair.
Yes, man of God. It's true.
It's true, man of God.
Here, there was no hair, like a bald hair.
Yes, yes, it's true.
You are given back to apostle. You don't know. If you know the child you give back to, you will not want to have any child. You just take care of that. But you don't know. Okay, so I wish you good luck. See you. Come on. Come on, Mama. Come on, Mama. How are you? Have you find what you are looking for? There's a document property, document concerning property. So you have to forgive. Yep. You learn how to forgive, okay? You are living in the past.
Okay.
Unforgiven spirit. Oh. This is what is controlling you. People have offended you so much. So please, you have to learn how to forgive, okay? Hi, how are you? Where's your husband? This is second disappointment now. I said this is second disappointment.
Yes, man.
Anytime you look at the mirror, you look beautiful, that beauty is deceiving you. There are many people, when they look at the mirror, they look beautiful. That beauty is deceiving. It can deceive people. So don't let your beauty deceive you.
Yes, man.
Because they don't want you to stay in the husband and stay with a man, because you know what happened last time. You are the one who used your property, your money, your everything to get a man. Yet they reject you.
Yes, man.
You know, there was a man who wanted to marry you. At the last, that was disappointed.
Yes.
And the man is in overseas now. It's not in, he has traveled away.
Yes.
It is very painful. And he believes without you come back or you two people marry, he will not marry, you will not marry.
I have a baby.
I know. So I want to see her, okay? Take her off. Said he said it disturbed the career. The spirit of God does not disturb the career. Please. How are you? You have problem with your organ.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's true, sir.
Come on. How are you? From where? Your dear one died. Are you just startled? Okay? I say he lost his dear one.
True man of God, it's true.
And for better, for worse, is their issue.
Yes, it's
and it's impossible she would have loved to die the same day and follow the person.
It's very true, very true.
Now, since that died, she has not recollected his senses. He's dead already. He's just walking.
It's very
she
true.
Need deliverance.
She's
because
sick.
He can't reason well. She can't do anything well. It's like the whole life is dead.
It's very true, man of God. Please help her.
Hold on. Can you go and have place later?
Continuamos el tiempo de profecía. Vean cómo el nombre de Dios está ministrando profecía, una palabra profética a todos aquellos.
You have an issue.
Yes,
okay,
man of God.
This is a bone of contention. You have to forgive this man.
Yes, man of God.
Because you find it difficult to forgive.
Yes, man of God.
It's naturally he offend you.
Yes, man of God.
But the Bible does not permit us to hold an offense.
Yes.
So this is the case. I will cancel you. Okay.
Yes, man of God.
You let go. You let go. Go. Okay.
Yes, man of God.
You can move forward. Because when you do that, you move forward.
Thank you, man of God.
Because there is an invitation for you.
Thank you, man of God.
Okay. Come on. Stand up. Take him off. Oh. So there is a serious generational curse of diabetes.
Thank you, man of God.
I want to see you.
Thank you.
So it's not the one that go to toilet often, but it weighs you, your bone, your heart.
Yeah, exactly, man of God.
And you cannot even, you don't have strength to satisfy your loved one.
Thank you, man of God.
I want to see you.
Thank you.
Come on.